I'm Anthony F. Elmore. On October 21st, 2019, our friend Reginald Tate passed away. In one way, Reginald was like a brother in that I was close to his sister, Trezette. While Father Time will have Brother Death to always pay us a visit, most of the time we hate to see Brother Death visit us. While we hate to see Brother Death, he too will always be a part of our family. What I know about Reginald Tate is his demeanor, his smile, his dignity. I have no sad image of him in my mind, and what I can offer those who knew Reginald as a shout out. I have this vision of doing trade with Africa, meaning Kenya. And I asked Reginald to help me out. I think this is like 2014. And as a state senator, he had me to come to his office in Nashville to meet Tennessee Governor Bill Haslam's commissioner of the Department of Economic and Community Development, Commissioner Randy Boyd. It was a big thing to meet Commissioner Boyd. In 2016, at our home in Orange Mound, we honored one of Kenya's founding fathers, Tom Mboya. In 1959, Tom Mboya started a program called Adopt America that brought a 23-year-old man from Kigolo, Kenya, to go to school in America, in Hawaii, and that young man's name was Barack Obama Sr. Senator Reginald Tate, along with Congressman Cohen, were the first in America to honor Tom Mboya's 60th. In fact, Reginald was right there with us when we honored Tom Mboya in 2016. Now, Black people do not know this, but the largest group of Black people who live outside of Africa live in India, where there are 300 million Black people called Dalits. Senator Tate, being on the board of the National Civil Rights Museum, gave our brother from India, Dr. Rajiv Kumar, and ourselves a tour. Instead of you seeing a deceased Reginald, we want to share with you red words of Reginald Tate speaking himself. This is a shout out to the man I call Ratman, and he called me Kickmo. We're going to honor Reg by carrying out this work and bringing us together with our family in India. Let's let you hear some words of Reginald Tate himself.
I'm Anthony F. Elmore. We're at the National Civil Rights Museum with Dr. Rajiv Kumar. And we have our beloved Tennessee Senator, Reginald Tate. And we are here to honor the legacy, not only honor the legacy of Dr. Martin Luther King, but we hope to bring the Dalit people of India into the Black movement. Senator Tate, we really want to thank you for bringing us here to honor us and honor the Dalit people. And we just really appreciate
that. You are both more than welcome.
Thanks so
much. One of the things we want to do, Senator, just as there's a Mahatma Gandhi, the father of India's constitution, and the most honored man in all of India was Dr. Rahimru Ambedkar. And by you being on the board of the National Civil Rights Museum, we want you to speak on behalf of Dr. Ambedkar. We'd like him to be honored here as well. And hopefully you could work on that.
We'll work on that.
And what you got to say, Dr. Rajiv?
It is actually the fight Dr. King for and Dr. Ambedkar was saying. They belong to the same movement.
So we're bringing the movement together. Let's do thumbs up here, pilot. Thumbs up. We're here with Tennessee State Senator Reginald Tate, Dr. Rajiv Kumar, and Anthony Elmore. Thank you very much.